This virus is very interesting for us because it's causing such different symptoms in birds and humans. Since this is causing no symptoms in the birds, it's flying under the radar screen, so to speak, which means that it might be more widespread than we realize. That's one of the major concerns for the Americas because it's not here. It's not established in our birds. The Chinese released sequences for the first four human cases very quickly. There's a lot you can learn just from getting the sequence information that can lead you on to other experiments and possibly field studies to try to confirm the suspicions you develop from the sequences. We know a lot about the virus just from the sequence, but it's also got some changes we don't really understand yet, which tells us that there's still a lot to learn about this virus. So we have to actually work with it in the laboratory to figure these things out. This one is showing a lot more human cases early on, the H7 compared to H5, since everybody is experienced with having to change the vaccine composition for seasonal influenza every year. We know that influenza viruses can change. That's something we have to be aware of. We have to see that we have a vaccine that works against what's in the population at the time. We're doing as much as we can, and our people are working very hard, and they know what they're doing. They're producing results at an amazing speed.